Let's dive into some news notes and nuggets in this week's edition of Hobby Happenings. Well, Ivan, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. has been in the bigs for less than a week and is already making an impact that is reverberating throughout the hobby. Last Friday, the new junior made his Major League Baseball debut, and Topps issued his first official rookie card the following day through the Topps Now program. The card, which featured his first career hit, which was a double that sent up a Toronto Blue Jays walk-off win, broke the Topps Now record, selling 19,396 copies, which eclipsed the previous record set last year by Shohei Ohtani by more than 2,000 cards. And then this week, Topps announced, to no one's surprise, really, I mean, come on, that Guerrero will be the mystery player A redemption in the following sets: Series 1, Heritage, Inception, Gypsy Queen, Big League, and Tier 1.
Guess you could say that.
Vlad 2.0 era is officially here.
That's awesome. In an update to an auction-related story we told you about earlier in the year, this week, the official copy of the signed score sheet from Wilt Chamberlain's 100-point game in 1962 sold for an incredible $214,579. Wow. Let that sink in for a minute. In other auction news, an item originally purchased at the famed Sotheby's Copeland Collection auction sale in 1991 that generated a then jaw-dropping sum of $3.2 million has resurfaced at SCP Auctions. That's right, seasoned collectors. You well remember that high-profile auction that took place in New York City in 1991 was where the famed and now tainted T206 Honus Wagner card was purchased in part by Wayne Gretzky. Which just goes to show you, grading is nothing new to the hobby. However, one of the true gems of the auction still remains one of the most significant and elusive sets from baseball's golden age during the 1920s, the fabled 1922 E121 American Caramel Series. Caramel or
Caramel?
Caramel. you bloke. Which includes more than 30 Hall of Famers, among them Babe Ruth and Ty Cobb. Purchased back in 1991 for $10,000 at that famous auction, the collector kept each card individually sleeved and paged in a binder. When submitted to PSA for grading before the sale, it instantly became the number one rated set on the PSA set registry. Well, it sold this past week through SCP for $60,000.
I love the fact that that gentleman bindered the cards and enjoyed them and never thought of slabbing them until it was time to consign them. Hey, if you're into digital trading cards, well, then Topps Digital Collectors Assemble. The all-new Marvel Collect app by Topps is officially here. Join forces and build the ultimate collection from Avengers Endgame and beyond. This exciting new collectible-based app puts the Marvel Universe in the palm of your hand. Download it free from the App Store or Google Play. My youngest daughter and I have been playing with it and getting ready to make some trades.
Ooh. Congratulations to CC Sabathia, who joined the 3,000 strikeout club this week. Very, very impressive milestone. However, two autograph hounds looking to capitalize on the ace's accomplishment got more than they bargained for at a Yankees road game against the Arizona Diamondbacks. You see, there are unwritten rules and policies with regards to professionals who have locker room access in any pro sport. One of those rules: no autographs. However, that didn't stop two Maricopa County, Arizona sheriff deputies who entered the clubhouse to do a routine security check from asking Sabathia for his autograph while they were there.
Bush League!
Sabathia politely and to his credit obliged. However, with that success in hand, they then targeted Gleyber Torres, and that's when things got heated as Yankees officials had to escort these law enforcement officers from the clubhouse. As a result, the officers ended up being benched by their boss, and the autographed baseballs were confiscated and returned to the Yankees.
Can't blame a guy for trying? Nah. Well, it's been a rough week for a couple of top-rated eBay consigners, grading companies, and some breakers that got caught up in the shady practices of a repack company with an already tainted reputation. There's been plenty of coverage on various hobby channels throughout the week, and we won't rehash it all here. However, we do encourage our viewers to avoid participating in breaks of any product from Heroes of Sport. And that's a look at this week's hobby happenings.